Breast screening using mammography is the best available screening program that we have, or that indeed is available internationally.
I'd like to see a cure. I'd like to see a guarantee. The biggest mind f**k about this whole thing is that there's no guarantee that it's going to be okay. And that's really hard to wrap my head around.
I just think that we've put men on the moon, and yet this is all we've got for the detection of breast cancer for women under 50. I think there should be something more, and I mean, why not have a crack and have a go?
I think the hardest thing is, I suppose in one day, you feel 24, and then in one day, your oncologist tells you, you're gonna lose your breasts, you're gonna become menopausal, you're gonna lose your fertility, potentially.
I find that a woman in her 60s has different concerns than a woman in her 30s or 40s. So it's really good to be in touch with women who are at my stage of life and dealing with it. My name's Renata Gortan. I was diagnosed with breast cancer last year when I was 32 years old.
Good boy.
Let's go.
We got Scoo just after my first chemo session. Even just for a walk around the block, he was a reason to get out of the house, and that really helped me. I was lying on the floor watching TV, and my arm was above my head like this. And it turns out that that's the ideal position to check your breast, because by stretching your arm up over your head, it stretches out the entire breast and it kind of flattens it. And then like my hand was just there. It wasn't like I was examining myself. It was just this fluke, just a freak accident. I was 32 when I was diagnosed, and it was stage 3, grade 3, which is, you know, pretty far advanced.
The current gold standard for detecting breast cancer is mammography, but it is only offered to women aged between 50 and 74 years of age. That's because younger women's breasts are too dense to be screened. Although young women are less likely to get breast cancer, their survival rates are much lower. That's partly because they rely on self-examination, so by the time they feel a lump, it might be too late.
The breast surgeon, I just remember he mentioned a mastectomy, and I hadn't even thought of that. And I was in tears, bawling, going, I can't do this. I can't. I'm too young, and this is bullshit, and this is not fair. I thought, you know, if you have a lump, you have a mammogram, they find it and then they treat it. You know, I needed an ultrasound rather than a mammogram because I was so young. Didn't know about biopsies, didn't know how much biopsies would hurt. But then, you know, everything about cancer treatment is intrusive.
But a chance discovery by young Australian scientists could soon change that.
There is a demand, especially for younger women, for a tool that can be used for them more often and more accurately.
Dr. Dharmika Mistry's eureka moment came when she realised that oils from cells with a telltale cancer signature were making their way into the bloodstream, and the breast cancer blood test was born.
So a blood test is revolutionary, really. There isn't one on the market at the moment. So the test would be as simple as having a blood test at the GP or with your healthcare professional. A blood test is available to women of all ages. We're seeing early indications of a very high accuracy of 90% for the most common form of breast cancer, and that means that it changes the ball game in terms of screening.
All these tests that you need to do to find out whether you have cancer, they hurt, and you have so many people poking and prodding at you. And if you just knew that you could do a simple blood test, I think a lot more people will get checked out.
Dr. Mistry is hoping to start clinical trials next year and to have a test on the market as soon as 2019. But according to the Cancer Council, there is still a long way to go.
Obviously, the holy grail of diagnostics is something like a blood test that can very simply be implemented. The problem with scientific discovery is scientists get very excited about their discovery, but there's a long pathway before that could ever be the replacement. It would have to be assessed head to head against mammography screening to see whether or not it not only captures more cancers, that those cancers are actually diagnosed earlier, and also that it alters mortality outcomes.
But for women living in regional and rural areas, a blood test can't come soon enough. Around 1 in 3 Australians diagnosed with breast cancer live outside the major cities. And although there is less prevalence of breast cancer in regional Australia, the survival rates are much lower. Poor access and participation in screening services like mammograms is part of the reason.
In Australia, we're a really big country. You've got rural and regional areas, and a lot of women might not have access to a mammogram clinic. And yes, we've got the breast screen buses going around, but you need women to participate and have it convenient. And I think a blood test can really do that.
So what role do you think would have been played in your life if there was a blood test that would be as easy as you going to a GP?
Oh, that would be the best thing ever, because I wouldn't have had to go through all the things I've had to go through.
I now am treating a chronic disease as opposed to something that's curable. I'm still trying to reconcile at 39 how many years I have. It's a really hard thing to reconcile.
I did the lumpectomy and then the mastectomy and then the really hard chemo and then radiation, and now I'm on tamoxifen. Like, I've done everything, and I hope that that's enough.
I'm not sceptical about the potential of tests like this, but to get your hopes up now that in the next 5 years that this would be able to be used instead of mammography, I think that that's unrealistic.
My dream is to just have this out there for every woman everywhere, around the world. I think everybody's always looking for their chance to make a dent, and I guess this is mine.